Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe Channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my New York Giants Connected Franchise Series here in Madden 15 on the PS4. So the Giants have been slipping a little bit here, now 4-5 after playing the Seattle Seahawks. That was a tough road test, and we did not pass the test, losing to the Seattle Seahawks, and now it doesn't get any easier as the 8-1 San Francisco 49ers come into town. And we got to try to turn things around and get a win at home and go to 5-5. Let's throw it to MetLife Stadium.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Cousins, Giants, going up against Kaepernick's 49ers. Now we'll go down to Jim Nantz and Phil Sims for this Week 11 matchup.
Giants, it's pouring here as we're getting ready for today's matchup.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz and Phil Sims getting set for the call. The playoff chase is on. It's late in the year, and every single game is crucial. How about the scene we have before us, Phil?
I'll just wipe the slate clean, Jim. That's what you got to think of as players and coaches. Don't worry about mistakes that you've made in the past or some of the good things. This is it. One game, it means everything. And if you have that kind of attitude, I think it really helps you play better.
Once again, we're playing in the rain today. Let's see how that goes. Kirk Cousins is coming out with the offense, and the Giants will have the ball first. So let's see what they can do against the Niners defense. Cousins gets into that huddle, and here we go. We want to get this going with the running game. Now, if at all possible, we want to have the ball in our possession for a big amount of time in this game. Have to control the time of possession as you see Jennings get a first down run, and we're going to continue to run him. He goes right up the middle. It'll be 3rd and 4 now. Cousins, a quick drop, and he's going to throw that to Finley, who's going to fight for the first down. So speaking of keeping possession, this drive rolls on into Niners territory. This pass is going to be to Jernigan. He comes back for the football, which was a nice play, not allowing the defender to get his hands on it. Then he turns back upfield and fights for that first down. So handing off to Jennings on first down, and he's not going to go down on first contact. He'll get about 6 yards, 2nd and 4, and we got a counter play. That's not going to get us the first down, but we're chewing this first quarter clock. Cousins, the quick throw to Cruz, and another third down conversion. Just a quick curl route, and we've got another first down. Jennings, nope. They know our tendency of wanting to run on first down right there. Cousins over the middle, though, to Jernigan for the touchdown. And there you go. We get in the end zone first and take a 7-0 lead on the 49ers. There is Cousins hitting Jernigan wide open over the middle of the field. So that run game set up the passing game and gets us our first score. So a great drive. 14 plays, 73 yards. Over 7 minutes of time of possession there on that drive. So Kaepernick's got to wait quite a while to get on the field with his offense. And hopefully we kept him nice and cold on the bench right there. You see Frank Gore fighting hard on 2nd and 9. It'll be 3rd and 3 now. And they're going to go Gore again. And he's trying to go outside. And that's great team defense. They're not going to let him get the first down. San Francisco will have to punt. That's a big play right there. So Cousins gets the ball back, and here we go with our short, quick passing game. That is going to be to Finley yet again. That'll set up a 3rd and 3. Cousins again, quick drop back, and Finley, no, not enough. He's going to be stopped short. It's 4th and 1. Decision to make right here. Coughlin not very happy they didn't get it, but pretty confident that we can get this with the fullback. Hynoski pushing forward. He's got more than enough for the first down and needed 1, and he got 5. So really wanted the ball in our possession, and we keep it by getting the 4th down conversion. There's a pass that is going to go to Finley yet again. Nice catch on the play action, and he's able to hang on. So here comes Jennings, stacked up on 1st down, maybe 2 yards. 2nd and 8 now. Cousins out of the shotgun and over the middle. It's going to be Odell Beckham Jr., who debuted in real life this last week. Was cool to see him on the field and catching a touchdown pass. 3rd and 4. That's a nice play to come back on that curl route and knock it down. So it's going to be a long field goal attempt through a slight wind and some rain. Does he have enough? No, it's going to be short, just out of Brown's range. So we do not cash in on this drive, and it remains a 7-0 lead. As you see that kick? Yeah, not quite enough to get it over the goalpost. So here comes Kaepernick now on 1st and 10. Nice pass to Anquan Boldin. Going to get them into Giants territory at the 43-yard line and a first down. Here come the 49ers before half. 4 minutes and change left. That pass is low, but Crabtree is able to make the catch. 49ers convert, and with 2:12 remaining, Kaepernick is going to throw again to the sideline. This time it's Vernon Davis getting a first down and getting out of bounds just before the two-minute warning. At the two-minute warning now, 1st and 10, Kaepernick throws, and that's going to be Vernon Davis in the end zone. The 49ers have a big-time drive right there. That is why we're trying to keep the ball in our possession as long as possible, because this Niners offense is every bit as explosive as that Seattle team we faced last week. Showing it right here, coming right on down the field, and it culminates in a Vernon Davis touchdown catch. So, yes, here we go. 4 of 6 for 53 on that drive was Colin Kaepernick, and we got a tie game. Minute 50 to play, and here's a pass to Odell Beckham Jr. He is going to be short of a first down. It'll be 2nd and 2. Cousins wants to throw, but he's sacked. He's sacked, and the Niners are going to take a timeout as it's 3rd and long. Can we convert? A quick pass to Jernigan. He adjusts behind him and makes the catch. It'll be 1st down. So there we go. The timeout backfires for the Niners. Going to Jernigan again, and he is across midfield to the 38. 2nd and 10 now, and the rush is on, but he gets this ball off to Randall. Randall's going to have about 7 or 8 yards. I'll give him 6, I guess. 3rd and 4. And we've got a timeout. So Cousins will talk this over with Tom Coughlin. And on 3rd and 4, big play. Cousins over the middle. Beckham makes the catch and gets the first down. We've got an injury, but that's to Chris Cook on the defense, not to one of our players. Cousins is going to hang in there and throw to Jermaine Grisham, who's going to fight hard and get a first down. Cousins having a nice first half. 16 of 19 for 138 and a touch, but they want to finish this off. 27 seconds and counting. Cousins to the corner of the end zone. Oh, what a catch in the end zone. Mario Manningham has the touchdown catch, and it's 14-7. 2 touchdown strikes in this first half by Cousins. This one to Manningham, and with just seconds to spare in the half, the Giants take the lead back at 14-7. What a play. All right, so there are a few seconds left, and here comes a pass to the sideline. Look at that, 1 second left. Vernon Davis, did he put him in field goal range? This is going to be about a 60-yard kick. Does he have the leg? Oh, that was quite a kick, but no. Beckham back there to return it. Yeah, you never know. See what he can get. Nah, he's not going to get very far, but maybe he catches him sleeping if they're not paying attention. So good first half of football, and we're up 14-7 on the 8-1. San Francisco 49ers.
All right, welcome to the Verizon Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Giants are involved in a very competitive game. The 49ers lead in time of possession, but it hasn't helped them dominate this game to this point. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Giants on 2nd and 7. Jernigan's found on the quick pass, and it leads to a touchdown. That takes the lead up to 7. 49ers have it late in the second. Kaepernick's got the completion from the gun. And after the short pass, he'll score. We're tied back up at 7. Still a little time left on the clock. Cousins got a completion middle of the field, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 38-yard line. Still late stages of the second. Quick pass is complete, and he capped off the long drive with a touchdown. That puts them up by a touchdown. So that's a wrap for us. We'll head back now to MetLife Stadium for the start of the second half.
1 half down, another half to go. 3rd and 2 for Kaepernick. And looking to convert this, he's going to run. Haven't seen much of this yet, but he gets good yardage right up the middle of the field as everyone was out in coverage, not paying attention to the speedy quarterback. 3rd and 1 now. What are they going to do out of the read option? They hand to Gore, and he stopped. Great job stopping the rush right there. They're going to have to punt on 4th and 4. So here we go, trying to get this ball control offense, trying to get the running game going. You see Jennings now 11 carries for 43 yards. Going to be a second and three play. First down for Jennings right there and more. So we keep this drive running. Third and one on the next set of downs. And he's going to get a first down there as well. He's up to 66 yards. 49ers do force a third and eight here. And we got a throw, and that's knocked down. So this is a punting situation as we enter the fourth quarter. Kaepernick gets the ball back just down seven. That's going to be a first down pass. And the Niners are looking to come back and tie the game. Kaepernick standing in there throwing to Stevie Johnson over the middle. And that's going to be a first down catch. And here we go again on first down. Kaepernick, no, he gets away. And now he's going to throw across the field. And he completes it. What a magician on that play is Colin Kaepernick, avoiding a sack and getting a first down pass. Here's a little more conventional play to Vernon Davis. Same result. The Niners are moving yet again. 6 minutes and change left on the clock in the fourth quarter. Kaepernick, first down strike to Bolden. He's going to be pushed backwards, but his forward progress gives him first and goal. Kaepernick looking to get in that end zone. He's going to run. Who can stop him? Oh, he stopped at about the 2 yard line. Second and goal. Hand off to Gore. Tries to go outside. Not going to get there. Stopped. As it'll be third and goal now. And they go play action. Looking for a quick throw. Not fooled. The Giants make the stop. That's Prince Amukamara on the tackle. And we've got fourth and goal and a decision for the Niners. They keep the offense out there. Wanting to tie this up right now. But he's sacked. Kaepernick goes down. Jenkins gets him. And that's a turnover. They get nothing. I thought with three timeouts and almost 4 minutes left, they'd maybe kick the field goal and rely on their defense. But here we had a run that went nowhere. Then we tried to get a screen pass that was not fooling anybody. We lose five there. Just trying to get the draw here and run some clock. But look at that. Oh, Jennings gets away and gets the first down. What a miracle run right there. It looked like he was going to get stopped in the backfield. He spun out of that and got first down yardage. That's frustrating if you're the 49ers trying to get the football back. Now they've got to burn their timeouts. The Giants are going to work this down as far as they can with this clock. There's another timeout for the Niners as they are trying to get anything back time-wise when they might get the football back. Now there's a stop on third and eight, a very conservative call yet again, just wanting to hang on to this. And now with 28 seconds and about 25 seconds when he punts this football, and that's a fair catch. Nice coverage right there. So they got to go 81 yards, and they don't have much time. Third and six. Kaepernick wants to throw. He's hit as he throws. That's incomplete. They'll have one more shot at this. Fourth and six with just 7 seconds left. I don't think Kaepernick can throw the football that far. No way he can. So let's see. He's going to try to step into this, and his arm is hit as he throws, and it's picked off by Beeson. The linebacker seals the game. It's a 14-7 victory. No points in the second half, but we did what we needed to do to get this game, and we now even our record at 5-5. Great home win. Wonderful home win right here as we knock off the now 8-2 San Francisco 49ers. This is obviously one of the class teams of the NFC, as was the Seattle Seahawks that we saw last week. But this time we get a victory. So Cousins, 19 of 24 for 152. Most importantly, 2 touchdowns and no interceptions. So he gets things done in the first half. Jennings just 1 yard short of the 100-yard mark, 25 carries for 99 yards. We will take it in a victory. As that running game solidified things in the second half, allowing us to run out the clock. Here are your receiving leaders. Odell Beckham Jr. with 5 catches, stepping up big time. And you see the rest of the crew as well. So we are now 5-5 as we get out of week 11. I know that in week 13, we play Junk Gaming Video's Jacksonville Jaguars, and that will be a fun head-to-head matchup of the two of us going head-to-head. But first, we've got the 5-5 Dallas Cowboys coming into town. Now, they beat us the first time around. We're looking for some revenge and looking to run our record to 6-5. So this will be a big-time battle. Come on back, Giants, Cowboys, next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.